Hello, this is H.G. Bailey, and welcome back to Let's Play Super Mario RPG. Today, we gotta go through Mushroom Way in order to get to the Mushroom Kingdom. So, let's go! Just like Bowser's Castle, we got random enemies to run into. Not entirely random, but I do want to fight them for the experience and gold or coins or whatever they're made out of. So, let's try out our timed hits we got here. Not bad. Not so good there. Oh well, let's try that again. Haha! There we go. That's more like it. See, I can't quite get it perfect every single time, but I hope that makes for a better LP, because I figure most people probably can't do it every single time. Now, one thing I'm doing here is that even though I still have some flower points left, I'm not using jump, because I want to save that for a particular enemy that you can meet up with around here. Yeah, unfortunately for now, we don't have a whole lot of flower points, so we gotta kind of budget them a little bit. Oh, there it is. Uh-oh, looks like Toad's in some trouble up there. Let's help him out. But first things first, let's take out this guy. See, a paratroopa, sky troopa, whatever they're called in Mario. These guys have pretty good defense, but they are weak to jump. Jump is sort of like its own element in the game. You got fire, ice, lightning, and jump. Not Earth for some reason, but oh, there you go. So yeah, jump is a really good way of dealing with these guys. Unfortunately, I'm not very good at timing my defense against them. So, oh well. Good enough. You don't even have to time your offense with jump. Their HP isn't so hot there, but alright, we got a mushroom from them. So yeah, you can win items from enemies here. Here we got a coin block, just like every other Mario game. Just jump on it over and over again. You get some coins out of it. Just hang on there, Toad. I want to get some money first. How did I go through that thing? I don't know. But anyway, we gotta rescue him. Again. This is the first time. Sorry. Whoops. Spoiler alert, this isn't going to be the first time that we have to rescue him. Or the last time. For the first time for the last time. But, alright, got him. So far, easy enough. Oh, by the way, something a lot of people were asking me. H.G. Bailey, are you interested in the Mario and Luigi games, or the Paper Mario games that kind of spun off this game? And, well, the answer is yes. I mean, it'll depend on the reception to this LP, but if you guys like it, well, I could probably get interested in doing some more. I haven't played them, but I am interested. I mean, I haven't beaten them. I've played some of them. Getting a little light on the HP there, but well, we'll make it. By the way, we got a honey syrup for rescuing Toad there. Recovers some FP, like an ether from the Final Fantasy games. But I want to save that for now, even though I could use it to use jump a little more. But, well, you'll see why in just a moment. Hey, alright, we got a level here. So, now, when you gain a level, just like any other RPG, you get a little bit of stat boost for a whole bunch of different stats. But more importantly, you get to choose whatever stat gain you want. Strength or power, HP, and magic, which they call star for some reason. But anyway, one of the interesting things about Super Mario RPG is that depending on whatever level you just gained, it will determine which one of these is actually best. Like, right now, we just got up to level 2, power, not gonna be so good. HP, not so good either. But magic, we get 3 attack magic there to our stat. That'll help out our jump attack, even though it looks like it's a physical attack, it's considered magical. So we wanna go for that for Mario there. But the way the level ups work is every 3 levels, each one of those will get a bigger boost than it would otherwise would normally. Like power, at level 3, you would get like 2 or 3 strength, probably. Level 4, you'd get more HP than what I could get here. Level 5, we got magic, gets a big boost. Then 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and so on. So, just something to keep in mind. For now, I want to go with magic, because that's what I can get the best on. Haha! Yeah, got that little spinning flower there. You press the B button when you're facing the right direction, and you can go over here. we get a little flower there. What that does is it increases our maximum flowers that we can get there. So now what I want to do, hop on there again. Uh-oh, Toad's in trouble again. Let's rescue him. Unfortunately, I don't have... Oh! How'd I get my HP back up? I must have gotten like an HP boost or something from one of the Goombas that I was fighting. Hey, I can one-shot them without jump now. Nice. Must have been that level up there. But anyway, alright, so we rescued him again, and what do we get? A flower tab! Yay! And what flower tabs do is you go to your menu, use it. It increases your flower points by one, but more importantly, it restores all of your flower points too. So now we can use four jumps before needing to refill. So what I want to do is I want to clear out all the enemies in this area off screen. Let's see, I think there's one up here too. Yep. So I'll take care of all these guys off screen and I'll be right back. Okay, I took care of all the enemies here and I used up all my flower points casting jump, if you call that casting something, but anyway, the reason why I did that, because over here, haha, we get a recovery mushroom that restores all of our HP and FP, so there you go. And by the way, one thing I will be doing in this LP also is I will be collecting as many of the flower tabs or those flower chests you just saw to increase my FP. I'll try collecting as many of them as I'm aware of. There are some mini games where you can get a lot of them too. And I'll try to do the best I can, but I may not get absolutely the max for each mini game, but should be good enough. I'll at least tell you where they are if I can't get all of them. So anyway, we got a new enemy here, Spiky, because they have spikes on their back. They're immune to jump, so we can't do anything with that. If only there were an item that would let me jump on them even though they're immune to jump. But sadly, I don't have an item like that yet. But anyway, okay, so we got the recovery mushroom there, we got the spiky guys here. Whoa, yeah, he's just gonna spawn those guys infinitely, I think. Wasn't there a guy there? Yeah, one thing I'm gonna try and do is fight each enemy at least once around here to get some reasonable experience. But yeah, I'm not gonna fight these infinitely spawning enemies all the time. Yeah, I'll just fight like one or two of them and then move on. Okay, so now we're getting close to the end of this area. Barely alive still. So let's use a mushroom to restore my HP there. You want to save at least 6 FP before coming to this point. That should be good enough, I think. Uh-oh. Hammer Brother. I could barely take on Bowser with a hammer. But anyway, okay, double check. Yeah, we're all good to go. Alright, it's hammer time! For boss time against the Hammer Brothers. So first things first, what I want to do is just stick to my regular physical attacks for the start of the fight here. So when you see their hammer at their apex there, when they're swinging it, that's when you want to time your defense against them. And so far I seem to be doing pretty good. Early on, the timing is pretty easy to figure out there. They've got, I think, 50 HP each, so we're doing pretty good so far. But once you kill one of them, he uses that. That's when we want to use jump now. Even though they're still going to reduce the damage, because Valor Up increases defense and magic defense, jump is still going to be a lot better than our physical attack there. Do that. Voila! Got it. Hooray! So... that was a pretty easy boss fight. And we get a flower jar. All right. It's like a flower tab, except it boosts your FP by 3. All right. All right, let's go. Oh, what's this? Sounds like a plan. Let's steal it. I mean, we killed them, so it's ours now. But alright, we got our first actual weapon in the game, the hammer. Mario starts out unarmed, or bare-fisted there. So, yeah, he doesn't have a whole lot to work with there. But if we go to equip, select the weapon we want, and it gives us a boost to our attack power. And it's going to have a little bit different timing than what the fist had, but we should still be in pretty good shape there. Oh, and also, I want to use that flower jar immediately. You could save it for when you actually run out of FP, but we're going to get some more flower tabs in the near future anyway, so I'm not really worried about it. And I want to get as many FP as quickly as possible. Flower tabs I will save for that, but like if it's a flower jar or something that gives me a significant FP boost, then I want to use that right away instead of saving it to fully restore my FP there. And let's see, well, we got the inn right here. Well, you know what, there is one thing I want to show you guys here. Let's see, we go down here, we got this guy. Okay, sounds like a plan. What for? Just to show off? Oh, what's that? It's a hidden treasure. So yeah, there's a whole bunch of these hidden chests lying around. Let me see if I can't get him into the corner there real quick. Okay, I can't seem to do it right away, I don't think. Yeah, there's a hidden chest around here, but I gotta get this guy to get over there in order to jump up and hit it, because otherwise I can't do that right now. I can't jump high enough. Oh, he's getting over there. Come on. Move. Move. Get closer. Move! Okay, well, if this starts taking way too long, then I'm just going to, yeah, screw it. I almost had him over there. Maybe I could have made it from where he was, but I don't know. But, okay, so I'm gonna try and figure out a way to get him over there. But can I get that hidden chest in the basement back there? What will the Chancellor do now that Peach has been kidnapped? Can we find the princess's secret panties? Find out next time on Let's Play Super Mario RPG. This is HC Bailey, signing off. Have a good day.